Avril Lavigne, Shania Twain, Alec Baldwin, Bella Hadid, Justin Bieber, Ben Stiller, Amy Schumer, and Richard Gere. Maybe you've heard of them. Did you know that all of these celebrities have been diagnosed or treated for Lyme disease? Hi, I'm Lyndall from VetSir, and today we're talking about a topic that's not just a concern for celebrities, but for our pets as well. Lyme disease isn't exclusive to the rich and famous. Dogs are at a high risk of contracting this tick-borne illness, and the number of cases is on the rise. In this video, we'll cover everything you need to know about Lyme disease in your dog. All of the information has been meticulously reviewed by leading vets to veterinarians, so let's hand it over to the experts.
Lyme disease has become a big concern for dog owners as ticks spread across North America. But what exactly is Lyme disease, and how do our furry friends catch it? Don't worry, we've got all the answers coming right up. First off, how can you tell if your dog might have Lyme disease? What will your vet do to diagnose and treat it? And maybe most importantly, how can you prevent it? While it's true that 90 to 95% of dogs who get Lyme disease might not show any symptoms, it's crucial to remember that the disease can be severe, even fatal. But here's some good news. There are several effective ways to prevent and catch Lyme disease early in dogs. Stick around because we're going to dive into all of this and more so you can keep your pup safe and healthy. Lyme disease, or Lyme borreliosis, is a type of bacterial infection that's spread by ticks. This isn't just a concern for dogs. It affects humans and various wild animals too. To keep your dog safe, it's all about prevention. Vaccination and tick prevention are your best bets. After all, it's much easier and cheaper to prevent the disease than to treat it. How do dogs catch Lyme disease? You might wonder if your dog can catch Lyme disease from other infected animals or pass it on to you. The answer is no. Lyme disease is only transmitted through tick bites. So when a tick that's carrying the bacteria latches onto your dog for a meal, that's when it can transfer the bacteria right into your dog's bloodstream. To help you keep your dog as safe as possible, let's go through the best steps you can take to minimize the risk of Lyme disease. Use vet-recommended tick prevention regularly. Check your dog for ticks every day. Remove any ticks you find right away. Keep your dog away from known tick habitats. Consider vaccinating your dog against Lyme disease. So where is Lyme disease more common? Ticks thrive in temperate climates, favoring wooded areas, brush, shrubs, and tall grass. They're most active in the early spring and late fall, but really, they can pop up during any warm month. In North America, there are four species of ticks that can spread Lyme disease, but the main culprit? That's the deer tick, also known as the black-legged tick. If you're in an area with lots of these ticks, the risk of Lyme disease is definitely higher. Here's something that might surprise you. Many dogs who get infected with Lyme disease don't show any signs at all. In fact, only about 5 to 10% of infected dogs will show any clinical signs of the disease. And for those who do, the symptoms can vary. Symptoms of Lyme disease include swollen joints or joint pain, swollen lymph nodes, lameness, fever, fatigue, loss of appetite. There's a serious complication related to Lyme disease known as Lyme nephritis, which is an inflammation of the kidneys that can lead to kidney failure. While it's rare, it's a severe condition that can be fatal. What's tricky about Lyme disease is that symptoms might not show up until 2 to 6 months after your dog has been bitten by a tick, and only in 5-10% of dogs. To protect your dog, it's essential to vaccinate, use tick prevention methods, regularly test for Lyme disease, and check your dog for ticks every day. How is canine Lyme disease diagnosed and treated? It starts with a blood test that looks for antibodies against Borrelia burgdorferi, the bacteria that causes Lyme disease. It's a straightforward test that can tell if your dog has been exposed to the bacteria. If you live in an area where ticks are common, your vet might recommend getting your dog tested for Lyme disease every year. This helps catch any infection early, before it becomes a bigger problem. If a dog does test positive for Lyme disease, the treatment usually includes antibiotic therapy, non-steroidal anti-inflammatories, pain management, supportive care for other symptoms. Even after treatment, Lyme disease can reoccur or relapse in the future if they're bitten again by infected ticks. This makes ongoing prevention crucial. In the early stages of Lyme disease, quick treatment with antibiotics usually leads to a good outcome by knocking out the bacteria early. However, if the infection spreads to critical areas like the heart, kidneys, or nervous system, it becomes much more serious and the prognosis worsens. Can Lyme disease be prevented in dogs? Lyme disease is serious, but thankfully, it's also preventable. One great step is to consult with a vet virtually on VetSir to pick the best tick preventative for your dog. This way, you can make an informed choice right from your home. The best defense against Lyme disease is to prevent tick bites altogether. You have several options, like topical solutions, oral medications, and tick collars that not only repel, but also kill ticks. These products are often part of a broader strategy that includes flea and heartworm prevention. It's crucial to talk to a veterinarian about which tick preventative is right for your pet to ensure it's safe and effective. Remember, not all products work the same, and some can be unsafe or ineffective. Also, if you have other pets, especially cats, make sure to mention this to your vet. Cats are highly sensitive to many topical products, and some that are safe for dogs can be toxic to cats, even if they just come into contact with a treated dog. Limit tick exposure. Reducing the risk of tick-borne illnesses starts right at home. By destroying tick habitats around your yard, such as tall grass, brush, and shrubs, you can really cut down on their numbers. It's also a good idea to discourage wildlife, especially deer, from coming into your yard because they often carry ticks. When you're out enjoying nature, try to stick to clear paths and avoid areas with tall grass or dense shrubs where ticks are most common. And even though these steps help reduce your exposure, they won't completely prevent ticks from finding your dog. That's why checking your dog daily for ticks is so important. If you find any, make sure to remove them promptly. What should I do if my dog has a tick bite? Okay, so if you spot a tick on your dog, the key is to get it off as soon as possible. Here's what you do. Grab some tweezers and carefully pull the tick straight out, right by the skin. Make sure you don't twist or squeeze it. That can make things worse. Once it's off, you should get rid of the tick by dropping it into some rubbing alcohol or wrapping it up tightly in tape. You could also flush it down the toilet. Next, just wash the bite area with some soap and water and then check over your dog thoroughly. And while you're at it, check yourself and anyone else around just to be safe. Remember, it can take a while for any signs of tick-borne diseases like Lyme disease to show up. And if you're not sure about removing a tick, or if you have other concerns about ticks, an online vet service like Vetster can be super handy to get some quick advice.